Hi friends, today I'm here to discuss a very interesting case. That patient came to clinic with a complaint of pain at the lower right and left posterior region. So in the OPG we found that there is a well-defined unilocular radiolucency which is represented by this yellow arrow. So this radiolucency is showing the thinning of the inferior border of the mandible. So we asked for the CT scan for the same to the patient. So this is the coronal section of the CT scan. We can see there is a loss of lingual cortex at the right side of the mandible and the inferior border of the mandible as well. This yellow arrow is showing the same. If we compare with the left side, so there is a definitive loss of a good amount of bone. And this is a 3D reconstruction of the patient. So in this we can see there is a thinning perforation of the buccal cortical plate of the mandible as well. So we have planned to operate this, and on the day of operation, what we did, so at the same morning my endodontist did the RCT of the right third molar to the second premolar, and this is the incision line and the marking of the mandible, and the pathology is shaded by the red color. Now the incision has been given to reflect the flap, and after the reflection of flap we have to reach to the mandible towards the pathological site. So once we reflect the flap, so we found there was a node at the level 1B region. So we have removed the level 1B lymph node, and after excision of this we have reached to the bone. So this picture is showing the removal of the level 1B node, which is a good large node as we found here. And after removal of this node, we have to explore the mandible. So this black arrow is showing the buccal cortex of the mandible, and as we can see, we have to reach the pathology through this cortex, and there we found some perforation, some thinning of the labial cortex as well. So with this, through this I have created a window to reach the pathology, and as we can see, this window is created and pathology can be accessed through this. And once we start this, so there was a thinning of inferior cortex as well,
the tumor which is inside the body of the mandible. And now look at here. So this is the tumor inside the bone. So what I did, I have created the window over the buccal cortical plate of the mandible. Now as I have mobilized this tumor from all surrounding of the mandible, so as the lingual cortex has been completely resolved here at the site of tumor, you can see here. So once I am retracting the lingual portion of the flap, the tumor is also coming out. So see, so now what I'll do, I'll completely enucleate the tumor from the all superior, posterior as well as the inferior border of the mandible. As there is no lingual cortex, so I'll remove the tumor from this side. Look at this. This one is a tumor. Yeah, so that portion was inside the body of mandible, so we'll remove it. So now I've retracted the tumor from the lingual aspect of the mandible. So this is the content of the tumor, and as my radiologist discussed with me, that this tumor in the CT scan was completely solid, like a fatty tissue. So surgically also I can see the fatty content of the tumor. It is not well encapsulated, so we have to be very careful while removing the tumor, so that the all content of the pathology has to be enucleated completely from the site. This is a part of lesion, the rest I will remove.
So this is the specimen and with the level 1B lymph node, which is a large node there, and the primary pathology. So the specimen has been collected, and these are the two jars, one for the level 1B node and one for the primary lesion. So after this, we have to make sure that mandible strength has to be maintained. So I placed recon plate over the inferior border of the mandible to maintain the strength of the mandible, and this is the final closure. And closure has been done in layers to achieve the proper functioning as well as the cosmetic appearance of the patient. So this is an interesting case, I found it, and nicely we have finished it. Thank you very much.